Talk to us now about the fuel subsidy, under recovery, whichever adjective you want to use about it now, because many wonder when the NNPC did say no more fuel subsidy or under recovery, and then, but you will still be regulating, because there are those who thought, okay, so if, why still regulate if there isn't going to be any more fuel subsidy? So could you shed some light about the rationale behind that decision?
I think regulation is the word that is clearly not put in context in public conversations. When you say regulation, it means there must be a state institution that ensures that ordinary people are not exploited by the market. This happens all over the world, and it's given many names, modulation, regulation, and any name that you call it. But when market forces come to play, the chances are that you can have some outliers who could try to take advantage of a situation like this and exploit the ordinary people. And that's why you need a regulator to create a band of prices within which marketers can play. But what we are putting in place today is a situation where the market forces will take control of the market. We eliminate this, whatever name you call it, either subsidy or under recovery. The reality today is that, you know, people don't pay for what they consume, and also the wrong people consume what others should consume. What I mean is this, the elites of this country, including myself, I'm not exempting myself. You know, when you say fuel subsidy, it's actually about the elites. It's the elites that have 4 to 5 cars in their house. They are the ones who have the SUVs that consume all the PMS that we know. But at the end of it all, you know, it turns into what is called under recovery, which is simply an NNPC buys product at market price, comes back to the country and sell it at sub-market price. And once you do this, you know, that cost must be recovered by law. And therefore, that recovery of that cost is what we refer to as under recovery. But where private sector are involved, this is where you have the subsidy scheme that everybody talks about. It's the subsidy scheme that we all know, you know, because of the arbitrage that is involved. That is why you have all the abuses that you have seen historically. That is why all the challenges that NNPC normally faces with the EITI audits over time. And of course, you see many instances where non-remittance of federation revenues for the wrong reason. Because when you say you don't remit proceeds, you know, it simply means that you have made the money and you didn't do it. But in reality, it doesn't happen. It is like smoking a cigarette. This country buys products, sell it at market, and then you dispose of it. And you can't see it again. But there's a cost attached to it. And that cost is what would have ordinarily used to build infrastructure, hospitals, education, and all that. And all those competitions, all those competing needs that are not addressed are what we use the cost of under recovery to do. And above all, you have a huge economic distortion when people don't pay for what they consume. And that means that you have the cross-border issues, which is because you are selling fuel at a far more lower price than the market price. And therefore, we are practically supplying the whole of West Africa. And any time we try not to do that, we have the fuel shortages in our country. And it's not sustainable. And of course, ultimately, because of that distortion, you know, states are unable to pay salaries. People are not able to get salary increases whenever they have. The minimum wages are not implemented in many states, and so many other implications of getting this distortion not resolved, which is why today, with the situation that we have in ground, which the market forces have introduced, which is that today you can actually deliver this fuel to the market at less than 145 naira to the liter. And going with time, you'll see gradual adjustment in this price. It can go down, it can go up. But when it does go up, it simply means that consumers will pay for what they consume. But ultimately, the ordinary man, the poor man in the country who is not shielded from this effect is the ultimate beneficiary. Because today, whatever name you call it, exploitation or any name that we put in it, you know, it simply means that, you know, this country is subsidizing the elites, not the ordinary people. The ordinary people are the victims. And this has to stop. And this is a decision of all of us that the wise thing to do is to transfer these benefits to the ordinary people. I don't know if this is your concern.